Hello and welcome to the vlog. So it's Sunday, I'm breaking out horribly, we hate to see it, but we're just, you know, making do. So I'm here with our lovely Margot. How are you today, Margot? Looking a little grouchy, but you know, you probably have the Sunday scaries. Oh, okay, all right. Sassy. So, I have some reading updates, but I also want to try a new recipe with y'all. I am craving a smoothie bowl. I've never made one, but I recently got a new blender, a big ninja blender, and I'm really excited about it. So, we're gonna make a little smoothie bowl and hope it turns out okay. So, we're gonna go do that now, because I'm kind of hungry, and let's just go do it. We got our triple berry mix. Got our giant blender. Alrighty, here is our recipe we are using. So let's get started. I am so impressed. This tastes like ice cream. This is amazing. It's so thick. It just is so much. I'm gonna put some in another container and eat some of it. But holy cow, I'm impressed.
Hello friends. So it is still Sunday. I accidentally took a really long nap. So I just woke up and it was great. But that smoothie bowl I made was amazing. It was like eating fruit. Ice cream. It was so good. Although I still really want to get a Ninja Creami because they are so cool. And I keep seeing people on YouTube take like peaches, just like the peaches you buy in a can or something, chop them up and then put it in there and make like peach ice cream. I'm like, I need this thing so bad. And like, I could make my own cookies and cream ice cream. And I am desperate to get one of those. So I have it currently on my birthday wish list because I like need one of those because that thing would be so cool. So anyways, I have some reading updates for you all, and then I'm gonna head down for dinner. I'm still reading Ninth House as my physical read, and it's going really good. I'm 163 pages into it. I still hope to get over the 200 page mark today before I go to bed.
Well, my camera died, and I seriously do not have the time or energy to go grab the other battery I have. So like I was saying, I still think I can get over the 200 page mark today before I go to bed. And I'm really glad I'm rereading this because there is so much that I have forgotten. And there's honestly so much that I don't think I understood quite as much reading it the first time. Like, this isn't a complicated book, but it's definitely one that I'm benefiting a lot from reading again. So it's going really good. I'm really enjoying it. It does read really fast when I do sit down to read. I just have not really done that. And then I took like an hour long nap, which I did not mean to do, but it happened. And so I also finished Along the Saltwater Sea today, which was really good. I really enjoyed it. I need to say that I finished this book on Goodreads and Storygraph because I haven't done that yet, but I'd probably give this book like 4 stars. I really enjoyed it. It was just really fun and a great continuation. I just really love it. Like, I feel like this book is so perfect for younger kids, but it's also so perfect for adults. Like, I feel like the age range could be for everyone. Like, there's like no specific age group that I would say this belongs to. I feel like it's like everyone. Like, everyone should read this, no matter how old you are. It's amazing. So with that being said, I need to pick a new audiobook. So I do have the audiobook for The Gilded Wolves downloaded, and I do want to get to this because this is a buddy read book for June. So basically, the way Cameron and I do our buddy reads is that we just read the book whenever during the month. Like, there's not a specific time to read it. We just read it at some point during that month. So I did just get this sent to the library. So I think I'll start this as my next audiobook. And then I will read the last book in the, I don't know what this is called, Over the Woodward Wall series, Into the Wind-Racked Wilds. So I think it'll be perfect to have like a little palate cleanser book and then read the last one. Really glad I finally caught up in this series. Like, I feel like I read the first one so long ago and didn't ever continue. So this will be my next audiobook. So that's my current reading plans. I do hope to finish Ninth House this week. If I can read like 50, 60 pages a day, I can't get it done by like Thursday or Friday. And I would like to say I should also be able to finish this as well, because it's not a very long book and I do tend to listen to audiobooks pretty quickly. So that's kind of the plans for the week in terms of reading. Obviously, I'm going to be working all week, and I do officially start in my position tomorrow, so I will be finishing up all my orientation paperwork, which I had started in like January, and then I stopped because they said, you know, we can't finish this until you're like officially here. So I have started the paperwork, it's just not been finalized or anything, so that'll be fun to get that all finalized. And then I need to get an ID card because I have one from when I was a temp, but I need to get one in my new position, so that'll be pretty cool. I might wait a few days for that to kind of kick in until my position officially changes and I'm not considered a temp anymore. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, nothing really changes for me. It just means that I'm official in the position and I can start accruing leave, which is huge. So I'm on a 90-day probation, so starting tomorrow, so I can't use any leave because, first of all, I don't have any. And also, I need to have at least 24 hours of leave in the bank before I can use it. I also have an evaluation after the 90 days. Of course, they could be like, you know, we're gonna get ready or whatever, which I highly doubt because I think I'm doing great, but we'll just see. And then now I'll be getting evaluations, which will determine how I'm doing and stuff. So yeah, pretty crazy. I'm official now, like officially tomorrow. So yeah, that's about it though. I'm gonna walk down to my parents' house for dinner as I always do. The benefits of living near your parents, you could just walk to their house every night for dinner and it's great. I mean, they're already making food. I might as well. And I mean, hey, it works out great because then I can hang out with them, eat some amazing food, hang out with their cats, which one of their cats is my cat, but she needs to live there because she's an old, old lady. And yeah, so I'm going to go do that. And then when I get home, I did get all my chores done that I wanted to today, which was great. I got my April, May wrap-up filmed, which was amazing. So I'll try to maybe start editing that tonight if I feel like it. But otherwise, I just need to maybe squeeze in a light exercise. I am honestly really burnt out from yesterday. We did the 5K yesterday, which went amazing. We did it in an hour. I was so impressed. And I can typically do like a 20-minute mile, which I know was like super slow, but that's just like walking. And I was really impressed how good my mom and I did. So we did really good. And then I just did so many chores yesterday that involved being on my feet. I think I did almost 20,000 steps yesterday. So I'm feeling just a little wore out from that, but I still want to get some sort of movement exercise in. So I'll do that when I get home and then just hang out with the cats and then go to work tomorrow morning. So that'll be the plan. I noticed I didn't update much during the work week, so I'm gonna try to do better this week. I'm basically just trying to find a routine and a schedule for myself, and like I feel like I got it down pretty good for like myself and what I need to do to like get everything I want to done in a day, including work. So now I just need to kind of get vlogging into that schedule slash routine. So that's basically gonna be it, and I will chat with you all later on.
Hello, happy Monday. Today was like the most exhausting Monday I have ever experienced. And also while I do this update, I'm gonna be playing with Holly because I need to play with her to wear her out so she will sleep instead of pounce on me all night. So anyways, I don't know, like I had work to do today. Like there was things I needed to work on, but it was just like not keeping my attention. My attention span is very low today. I really should have had some caffeine of some sort to help. And I think it messed me up that I took a nap yesterday. So I think that's why I'm just so like out of it and just like really emotional for no reason. Like I'm not a very emotional person, like on the daily. Like I cry maybe like once a year, if that. Like, I don't know. I used to be super sensitive and super emotional, but I don't know, as an adult, I'm just like not, I guess. But anyways, so I wanted to come on here. I have some book mail, which it took me a little bit to remember what book this is, but I'm like 85% sure I know what book this is, so let's get into it. This literally was like packaged to go like around the world, and it kind of did. It's from the UK, which is exciting. If I can open this. Oh my gosh. This is the box. I literally had to like rip it in half, but it is Sea of Souls by R.E. Palmer, which I have a character that is inspired by me in this book, which is very cool. So if you're new to my channel or you don't know, I am beta reading this series, and this author reached out to me like years ago and asked like, hey, do you want to read this series? And usually I'm like, absolutely not. Like anytime an author does that, it really kind of irks me. And like, I always just delete it and never respond because it's like, no. I kind of looked into this and it was like the first time I've been asked to beta read a series, and I was intrigued. So I read the first book and I really liked it. It was really good. The second book was really good. This third one wasn't my favorite, but I gave the author some feedback and I believe he worked on it. So I'm excited to possibly reread this one and see what changes are made, because there was a very, very, very long battle sequence in this book that was probably a good couple hundred pages, I think. And it was just too much. Like, I get having a battle scene and having it be long and drawn out, but it was just like too much. So I know he cut back on that quite a bit, and I'm really excited. I know one of the characters in here is named after me, and it's really cool. So, Boo Assist, the fourth book in this series, is due out in December of 2023. So I'm sure I'll be hearing from him soon to start beta reading that. So that's exciting. This series honestly reminds me a lot of The Shadow of What Was Lost by James Islington, which is like a long journey series with like enemies. And there's this one character in particular who like I'm obsessed with, besides, of course, the character inspired by me. I'm forgetting her name. I think it's like Elodie or Elodie. Like, I don't know how you pronounce her name, but she's one of my absolute faves. And it's just so cool to have this in paperback in my hands. So really excited to have this. Thank you so much to the author for sending me a copy. I very much appreciate it. So as for reading updates, I did indeed get over the 200 page mark in Ninth House last night. So I'm on page 221. I don't think I'll be reading too much tonight. It is already 9 o'clock and I have yet to take a shower and kind of do my night routine and pick up my outfit for tomorrow and stuff. Thankfully, I don't have to pack my lunch tomorrow because my mom and a coworker are going out for lunch, which totally reminds me I need to do something before I get ready for bed. So that just reminded me of something. But anyways, so loving my reread. I am loving the audiobooks for this series, which I'm only on the first book, but I imagine the audiobook for the second book is going to be really good too. I just love the narrator, and I'm so glad I reread this because there's so much I forgot. And I have a feeling I'm getting close to the chapter where that one particular scene happens that everyone is just like, oh my gosh, that's like the most disgusting thing ever. I honestly can't remember what it is. So I kind of feel like it's coming up soon, and I'll be interested to kind of like remind myself of what that even was, because I can't remember. And then I did start The Gilded Wolves today as my audiobook. I am listening to this kind of slow. I have it at 1.75, which is like so slow for me because I usually listen to everything at like 2 or more. So I think I got like 20% into it today. I'd have to check my phone, but I made it a decent chunk into this. I did listen to this a bit at work because I'm working on a project that is really, really boring and I don't really need to think for it. I just need to like compare things to each other, and that's really easy to do without having to think about it. Like, as long as they match, you know, it's good. So I plan on maybe listening to more of this tomorrow while at work, but we'll just see. I'm still working on that project until my supervisor gets back on Wednesday, so we'll just see. But it's going good. Really glad I'm rereading this as well because I have forgotten like everything. So this feels like a brand new book, especially because I'm listening to the audiobook, which I don't think I did before. I really like the narration style. There's two different narrators, and I forgot this book is set in like France. Why do these characters have such strong, thick French accents? But it's set in like Paris. And I'm like, oh, I like totally missed that detail when I read this book the first time. So quite enjoying it. And I still think comparing this book to Six of Crows is just ridiculous, and people need to stop doing that. I'm just glad today is done. It was just, it was fine, but my parents recently got the same internet that I have, and they did not have a very smooth install like I did because their house is a lot older than mine and it has a lot of metal. So the internet company people were having a really difficult time trying to install the internet, and I just felt immensely guilty for all the hardships that they were having with that today because my mom had to take off work and go be there, and there she was like gone for like 2 hours, and it just made me feel really guilty because I recommended that this internet's like really good and that they should get it because now it's available for them. So I just feel super guilty, but like it's working now and I was able to get all their devices connected to it and it's working, but it just, I still feel really guilty that it wasn't like the most perfect smooth install like mine was. So anyways, it was fine. At least it's done and over with. So I'm just gonna get ready for bed now and I will chat with you all probably later on in the week. I did finally schedule last week's reading vlog for tomorrow, so I'm gonna try to keep up on that schedule. Let me know if you like Tuesdays as a weekly reading vlog day. So my new schedule is I'll stop a vlog on Friday and give myself Saturday and Sunday to get it edited and ready, make the thumbnail, and then Monday I will upload it while at work and then have it be scheduled for Tuesday. So let me know if you like that schedule. I can certainly schedule the vlog later on in the week as well, but it doesn't really matter to me. As long as they are uploaded on Monday for whatever day, I'm happy. So I just picked Tuesday because it's like the next day, so might as well. And yeah, so I will work on my April May wrap up, which I filmed the other day, so need to get that edited, and I hope to just read for the rest of the evening, but I also would like to squeeze in some editing at some point this week if possible. But that's gonna be it for this update and I'll chat with you all later. Hello, it is Wednesday night and I have been reading a fair bit, to be honest, but what I really want to do is unbox this giant Amazon box with you all because I ordered some new lunch boxes and I'm really hyped about them, so let's get into it. Okay, first of all, I did get 2 salad containers, which I'm really excited about. So they are, I think, like 54-ounce salad bowls, and they are dishwasher safe. I got them in this beautiful, like, sagey green, and I'm really excited because I wanted, like, a nice salad container for lunches, and this is perfect. And it even comes with a little fork. My sink is suddenly making very weird noises. I hope you can't hear that, but it's normal. Anyways, here are the lunch boxes. I believe I ordered 5 of these because I wanted to have enough for the weekday. So here they are. So you just unsnap it and then you can take it off, and it comes with silverware, which is cute. I don't know if I would use these, but I love the idea. So then you have this layer, and then you can pop it off, and you have this layer, so you could probably fit some, like, you know, fruit, veggies, and stuff. You could probably fit, like, I don't know, like a few cookies or something right here. And then the last layer, it would be like where you put your sandwich or pasta or whatever, like your main dish. This is so cute. They're a lot smaller than I was expecting, which is perfect because this would be like my lunch. Like, I could fit my whole lunch in here and this would be all my food for the day. So very excited. I'm gonna pack my lunch in there and I might do like a little make lunch with me, a little montage thing, because I don't feel like having a salad tomorrow for lunch because I had a salad on Monday and Tuesday for lunch, so kind of tired of salad. But I think we'll make my lunch real quick and that'll be fun. So as for reading real quick, I have done quite a bit. I'm over halfway through The Gilded Wolves and really loving my reread. I'm really appreciating the audiobook so much because I just do not have time to physically read this book. And I like the audiobook so much more. It almost feels more adult in audiobook form than it does physically reading it. So having a great time with that. I am really enjoying it and so glad I am rereading it. And then I'm over halfway done with Ninth House. I should definitely finish that this week, hopefully in this vlog. I'm loving it. It's so good. I did read the chapter where the, like, super disgusting scene happens. It's not as gross as I remember. Like, I don't know. I mean, it's obviously gross, but it's like not like the worst thing. I mean, it's very fitting for what that character deserves, which is all I'm gonna say. But anywho, so that's all I got for reading updates, really. Oh, also, I actually have an Illumicrate box to open, so let's do that real quick. Well, in actuality, I already opened this box, but I just thought I would show you all the items. So we got this super cool little tote bag thing. I'm obsessed with these. I use these for everything. I have one for my scrunchie holder, one for like hair products. I have one for, it's like a tissue holder, which is super cute, and I think that's it. I think I only have three, but I love these. Really excited to have another one, and I just love it. Then we got this super cute plant pot, which honestly is really small, so I didn't expect it to be huge, but I don't exactly know what plant I could use this for. Like, it doesn't have a drainage hole, so it'd have to be a plant that already has one. But look at the design. It's absolutely stunning. I'm obsessed with it. I just don't know what to use it for. Like, maybe this would be a good like TBR jar because it's kind of small, but I'm obsessed with the pattern. It's so beautiful. Or I could get like a fake plant, put a fake plant in here. That would be gorgeous too. Then we got this beautiful metal bookmark that I am truly obsessed with. I love the ocean. Like, it's one of my favorite things to read about, especially when it comes to fantasy. Heck yeah. So super excited to have that. And then we got this pop socket. I am not a pop socket girly. I have never had a pop socket on my phone that I have not just immediately ripped off. So don't know where I would put this, but I was honestly thinking of my Kindle because first of all, it's bookish, which is fun. But then it'd be nice to like hold my Kindle with just like one hand, which I could do how it is now, but I just feel like it'd be nice if I could just, you know, hold it with like a pop socket. So I may try that, but we'll just see. And then for the book, because I believe that's it for the items, we got Witch King by Martha Wells, which I really want to read. So excited to own this. We have beautiful stenciled ombre edges. I think they're ombre. I don't think they are. I think it's just the lighting makes them look ombre. And then we have stunning end pages and some beautiful foiling. So that is the book and the items, and this is the box for May, I believe. So there you have it. So without further delays, because I feel like I'm just procrastinating at this point, let's make my lunch. Here is my kitchen counter. Here is my brand new lunch box. So let's crack into it. Clothes, and I really shouldn't have, but the deals were incredible, so we're gonna do a little fashion show off. First up is this gorgeous blazer. I'm obsessed with it. This was my outfit today minus the blazer, but it obviously doesn't match. I just had to show you all, but like, it is so pretty. It's just like this light gray. It has buttons, so like I could like button it up. I feel like a professional businesswoman, and like no one's gonna tell me no, you know? Like, I'm obsessed with this blazer. It looks so good. Like, I'm obsessed. It is so comfy. It has like cute little pockets. I think
think those are fake pockets. Yeah, those are fake pockets, but still, this was in clearance. Originally $90, I paid $26. Like, are you kidding me? I've been wanting a blazer for so long, but just have not found one that I love, and I'm obsessed with this. Next up, I'm obsessed. It's this cute little like light blue kind of, I wouldn't call it a maxi dress, but it's like a light blue button-down dress. And this gives me like Reagan from Prue's Project vibes. Like, I feel like this is a dress that she would totally wear. And she's an icon. We love her. So I love this. And of course, it has pockets. And I think this would be a perfect work dress because it has a good length on it. Like, I would feel comfortable wearing this to work. And then like I could wear like a sweater or like a t-shirt underneath to kind of make it not so like spaghetti strappy. Not that that really matters, but like I work in government and I feel like this needs a little something for the top, but I'm obsessed. It's so comfortable. I didn't try on anything in the store because we just didn't have time. And plus, if I didn't like anything, then I could always take it back. But I'm obsessed with this dress. It's so comfortable and so cute. Okay, here's the final dress. I feel like I look like a grandma in this dress, but again, it'd be a perfect work dress because the length is right, and this one I would just like wear how it is. It's very comfortable, very swishy, and of course has pockets, which I kind of think is the necessity at this point with dresses. So that's my little dress haul. So yeah, I love it. It's so comfortable, and I think I bought all three items for less than $60, which is insane. And speaking of buying things, I know I kind of went crazy today, but one of my coworkers who works in the digital services department posted on like our SharePoint drive thing that she is selling a gaming computer, and I'm like, ooh. And the price was really good, like it was really cheap. And so I messaged her because I said to message her if you wanted to know the specs. So she told me all the specs of the computer. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is like a really good computer. So I'm like, sold, I'll take it. So I went to the bank and I withdrew some cash, and I will be picking that up tomorrow. So that'll be super fun. I have been wanting to get a gaming computer now that I have like this giant monitor set up in my room. It's great. I love it. It works really good for my laptop, but I was really hoping for like a stationary computer for that monitor as well that I could just like play games on. And my desktop most certainly cannot handle that anymore. She's gotten too old, which is why she is perfect for streaming. And my laptop's great for gaming, but I don't love gaming on it because it's really bad for the battery. You know, it just drains it. So I'm really excited to have a gaming PC. It is Windows, which I have had really terrible luck with Windows devices. They always seem to die on me, like no matter what. I had a Windows PC, I killed it. I think I got a virus and it died. And then same with my Windows laptop I got like so many years ago, I killed it. So I hope I don't kill this one. So hopefully it stays alive. And I think the problem was that I would download this game that was very sketchy, and I downloaded it on every computer I had, and I think that game like has a bunch of bugs in it and would kill my computers. So we're not gonna install that game. I know it's like super fun. It's called Alicia Online. It's basically Mario Kart on horseback. I feel like I've talked about this game before. It's super fun, like I'm addicted to it, but it just brings a ton of bugs, so it's not worth it. So we're not gonna download that, but I can get Steam on there and play Stardew Valley and all sorts of other games, and it's gonna be great. Like, it's a really powerful computer and it will be perfect for my big giant monitor that I have. So anyways, it is dinner time, so I'm gonna go walk down to my parents' house, have dinner, and I have chores to do tonight as always, but I'm hoping to read tonight. Like, I didn't really read yesterday because I got home kind of late, but I'm hoping to just blast out a ton of reading. And then tomorrow my mom is taking half a day off to kind of work on our garage sale that we're doing on Saturday. So I'm on my own for lunch. So I'm gonna go drop off my library books because our library is closed right now, which is really sad, but we're getting a giant expansion, which is gonna be so cool. So I need to stop by their temporary headquarters and drop off my library books that are due next week just to get them off my plate, and then just go eat lunch. So that's
the plan for tomorrow. I will come chat with you all tomorrow, give you all some final updates and close out the vlog and hopefully be done with Ninth House by then. I mean, I think I have like 2.5 hours of like reading time left. So if like I read for an hour tomorrow and like an hour today, I would have that book done, but we'll just see. I don't know if I have that much time to read right now, like today and tomorrow, but we'll just see, especially because I know tomorrow I'm gonna wanna play with that new computer and get it all set up and play with it. So not really sure if I will be up to reading, but we will just see. But like I said, gonna go down for dinner now and I will chat with you all later. Hello friends, I should have been asleep like an hour ago, but I really wanted to finish Ninth House and I successfully did so. I loved this reread so much more than the first time that I read this book. I truly just love this book so much. Like the characters are so messy but like so realistic, and the narration for this book was incredible. Like I wasn't expecting that, but it was really good and so immersive, and I just devoured this book. So really pleased I finished it this week. I was really hoping I would finish it in this vlog, and I did. So I definitely will not be finishing The Gilded Wolves in this vlog, so that will be in next week's vlog, but at least I finished one book, which is great considering how busy it's been. So tomorrow my mom and I are hosting a garage sale at our house, well, at my parents' house, and it's gonna be wild. Like there's so much stuff that we're selling, and it's mostly from a friend of my parents who passed away, so we're mainly selling a bunch of his stuff because his daughter isn't here to do it. And I mean, we have all his stuff. Like we took everything from like his apartment and his like storage area and stuff, and have just been keeping it in both of our houses. So now it's finally time to sell it all. So I think we're just selling his stuff. We're not gonna include any of our stuff that we've been holding on to for a garage sale. I think we're gonna wait and do that next weekend, just because we have so much stuff that it's already like a lot. So I think we'll just focus on that and then add in our stuff with whatever's left on next weekend. But anyway, so that's tomorrow's plan. So I doubt I'll be reading or hanging out much tomorrow. And then Sunday, of course, is Father's Day. So not entirely sure what we're doing for that. I know we're doing a big breakfast and dinner out with some friends, but I don't know what else we're doing. But also super exciting news, I got my gaming computer today. So I bought it from a coworker. I think I talked to you all about this, but I am obsessed with it. I got it all set up today. I did have to take one quick trip to Walmart and get a wireless plug and play adapter because this computer only has Ethernet for internet. And I do have an Ethernet cable that I could string from my room all the way into the living room. It's just a big pain. Like I wish it was wired into the wall. So I really wanted something wireless. So $40 later, I got that. That was really expensive. Like I thought it'd be cheap. I'm like, that's expensive. But it was able to connect to my internet, so I'm at least able to like have wireless connection, which is amazing. And I'm obsessed. So let me show you my newly arranged desk setup, because this computer is a beast. I was not expecting it to be so huge. It was not as expensive as I thought it was going to be, but I was looking at a computer on Amazon that was only $100 less, and it was way worse. Like, I mean, the specs on that computer that I was looking at were nowhere near the specs of this computer. So let me show you. So look at this big beast. Like, oh my gosh. So it's a giant tower. Like it's huge, and it has this beautiful like little opening so you can see inside. So it has a GeForce graphics card, which is amazing. Big old power supply in there. The hard drive is tucked away in here. Well, it's a solid state drive, but which is way better.
and we got our RAM. This is so dark. I'm sure y'all can't see anything, but we got RAM in there. The CPU is over there and it does light up a little bit. You can see like the GeForce GTX, like that lights up when you turn the computer on, which is fun. So here's my little itty bitty little like network adapter thing. I definitely would like to buy a better one sometime that like actually goes into the computer and connects in, but this was just a really quick fix just so I can play with the computer and get it going. We also have a little DVD drive in here, which is fun. So then now I can use my big, giant, beautiful widescreen monitor and play games. So I got Stardew Valley and this horse game that I'm kind of obsessed with downloaded, and they were great. I may want to upgrade the RAM at some point in the computer. It only comes with 8 gigs, which is good, but my laptop that I have has 16 and I'm kind of stuck on 16. Like 16 is perfect for everything that I do, especially gaming. Like it just makes for a very smooth experience, and the computer didn't even like flinch when I was like playing a pretty intensive game on it. So it's not really a big deal, but like eventually I would probably like to upgrade it to be 16, but not a big deal. I mean, I'm happy to live with that because it's an amazing computer for an amazing price, and actually it was really funny. So I get back upstairs because my mom helped me take it out to my car and put it in my trunk, and the coworker I bought the computer from was like, my husband actually meant for me to post that for another $100 more. And I'm like, I was thinking to myself, I really don't want to have to spend another $100 because like I feel like I've spent enough on this computer. And I'm like, oh dang, I'm like, are you sure? And then she's like, well, let me talk to him. So then she talked to him and then she was like, never mind, he said it's fine. And that if the computer had 16 gigabytes of RAM, he probably would have asked for another $100. But since it was only 8, he said it was fine. I'm like, good. Cause I'm like, I don't really want to have to like try to scrounge up another $100. So anyways, I'm obsessed with my new computer. It's a dream. It's so nice and it was so easy to set up. And I feel really comfortable having bought it from people who work in the digital services department because they work on computers all day long. And I just felt very comfortable buying it from them because I know it was going to be perfect, and it truly is. I definitely could have some upgrades to it, which is fun. I've always wanted to build my own PC, but just never knew where to go and like what to get. Like obviously I know the components I would need, but like I just never did it. So now I kind of have like a base model that I feel like I can just upgrade from here. But it's an incredible computer. I'm obsessed with the tower. It's huge and beautiful. I would love to get some lights in there and stuff and just make it pretty. But anyways, I seriously should have been asleep an hour ago because I have to get up extremely early tomorrow to finish up the garage sale, and then we're doing our garage sale from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. So I need to go to sleep so I can like wake up and go help my mom and stuff. So we are gonna end this vlog here. So if you made it this far into the video, comment some computer emojis in honor of the big girl over there. She's just stunning. So anyways, thank you all so very much for watching. I hope you all are doing well, and I will see you all in another video soon. Goodbye.